time now to announce the names of our five finalists. Since these 10 ladies standing here on our stage were chosen as semifinalists tonight, you at home have seen and heard everything that our celebrity panel of judges has seen and heard. Now it's time for you to match your opinions with their selections. This time, the scores you will see on your screens for each of our finalists reflects her average score for tonight's three semifinal competitions. Now, let's learn who our judges have chosen as our five finalists tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, the first name on the list is Miss USA. Number two among the finalists is Miss Finland. And Miss Poland. Number four is Miss Venezuela. And now the last name, number five, Miss Colombia. When the pageant year began, there were thousands and thousands of dreams all over the world. Then there were 77 of them on this stage. Then there were 10, and now there are five. And one of those five dreams will come true for the new Miss Universe. All previous scores are now discarded, and we'll be starting fresh with our final five.
Tension is a given. I know that I can feel the nervous tension in this very live audience here tonight. And so too, of course, are hard work, rehearsals, photo sessions, interviews. But these young ladies are not going to let language barriers or anything else keep them from having fun. Good for them. And as you're about to see, they did just that. From all over the world, they came via Eastern Airlines with great expectations of what they dreamed they would find in Panama. They would travel from down under to dance in marvelous discos. They would come via Miami from Europe and Asia to enjoy the exciting shops and wonderful food. They would even fly from other South American countries so they could experience the unique wonders of Panama. Aboard these flights, the anticipation was running high. The resort island of Contadora, where skiing conditions are always good, was just one of the places where they made it happen. Another was Bambito, in the mountain province of Chiriqui, where they didn't build a bridge over troubled waters. They jumped in a raft and enjoyed them. Rocking and rolling was not just something to be done on a dance floor. It was something to be done on the Piedras River. And their reaction was obvious. For fun, there are certain musts, and food is a big one. So there was a barbecue in Boquete. Now back to the water. This time, it's hovercraft with Panamanian registry and a crew from England and Denmark. Their boats and their spirits were both up in the air. We'll have a good time, baby, don't you worry. For some, the transportation was more basic, but just as much fun. Whether it's Bambito or Belmont, pretty ladies and beautiful horses go together perfectly. Since pretty ladies always want to look prettier, one popular stop was the makeup clinic, conducted by Stan Place, for Maybelline, the official cosmetic of the Miss Universe pageant. I'm about to lose control, and I think I like it. Oh, yeah. I'm international pastime for young women all over the world. It's called shopping. And wearing their Catalina sportswear, our ladies made the most of Panama's shops and boutiques. As night follows day, we know what follows shopping. Dancing. These ladies seem to be made for dancing. And so do their kinny shoes. Two popular phrases here. Mi nombre es Panama, and keep smiling. That very special group of women who have worn the crown of Miss Universe is getting ready to welcome its 35th member. Who will she be? We'll move closer to learning that answer when we come back after this word from Prel.